What's up, everybody? Welcome to Money Management Channel. My name is Andrei, and today I'm going to be doing an update on CTRM stock. First of all, brief information about this company. Castor Maritime engaged in the provision of shipping transportation services through its ownership of dry bulk vessels. And here is their website. You can read all the information by yourself, but just a sneak peek on their press release section. As I mentioned in my previous video, they have a lot of money and they almost double their fleet from the beginning of this year. And we have recent news that Castor Maritime announced delivery of the MV Magic Venus and the new chapter agreement. And here is the news. And it says Castor Maritime took delivery of motor vessel Magic Venus in a 2018 Japanese-built Kamsarmax dry bulk vessel. It had agreed to acquire on February the 1st, 2021. MV Magic Venus acquisition was financed on its entirety with cash on hand. The vessel is expected to commence employment under a time charter agreement on or about March 5th with a daily gross charter rate of $18,500. And an expected term between minimum 5 of about 7 months. It is estimated to generate around $2.8 million of gross incremental revenues for the minimum scheduled period of the charter, and around $4.2 million should employment extend to its maximum period, in each case assuming no off-hire days. And let me show you this vessel. Here it is, and we are on marine traffic. It is just a sneak peek on the vessel itself. Here is its photo, and as you can see, the vessel departed from Kobe, Japan on February 23rd, and it's currently sailing at 11 knots with southwest direction, heading to Adang Bay, and with reported estimated time to arrival at March the 8th. In 3 days and 9 hours, it will be at the destination point. And we, as well as on the marine traffic website, and as you can see, Nasdaq listed Greek ship owner Castor Maritime has taken delivery of its first Kamsarmax, and the vessel will immediately go out on charter. So they are working on their fleet. They are working to move the goods from different parts of the earth. And that's why, as you can see, we don't have so many sales among institutional investors. And let me compare the sellers and the buyers. First of all, sellers. As you can see, the recent sales was made on February the 16th, and this sale of Millennium Management was just a $13,000 sale, and this one was just $31,000 sale. And let me show you the buyers of this company, and here you can see the most recent buys was of $55,000. Next one was on $756,000. 2019, $275,000. Almost $1 million on February the 16th. And as you can see, February the 16th, it's not the best price point. It was right here. It's not the best price point for the investment. Nevertheless, these companies, these investors are hold strong their position. And that's why I think it is a good sign. But you have to keep in mind that we have these two articles. This was the first one, and it says that CTRM stock should cost about $0.25. And the second article that I mentioned in my previous video, as you can see, it was published on February 28th. It says a short squeeze incoming, Castor Maritime, CTRM. And here is the link of this news. And let me open it right here. And the page is not found. It's strange, isn't it? And my thoughts on this is that we have two possibilities. First of all, it was some kind of scam, and it was some kind of misinformation of potential investors. Or the second assumption is that someone want to push the price of the stock down and then buy back this stock, and that's why you cannot find this article on this website anymore. But everything that was on internet remains there forever. And let me show you this article. And we are on webarchive.org, and I will put this link in the description. And here you can see that we are on MarketWatch.com press release, short squeeze incoming Castor Maritime CTRM. And this sneak peek was made on February the 25th. So it is exactly at the time when this article was published. And you can read it by your own, and you can decide, is it a legit article, and is it a legit company or not, and is these facts legit or it is a fake fact. And you have to do your due diligence by your own. Only in this case you can make your own decision to invest or not to invest in this company. So, and before we dive deep into the technical analysis, please subscribe to my channel with the notification bell. In this case, you won't miss my next video, and hit the like button. This helps me a lot. So, here you can see my previous setup for the trade, and we've hit stop loss, and losses is around 15%. But for those of you who ladder your buys down, as I recommended always, you can reduce the percentage of your losses by several percent. Nevertheless, this trade was failed, and I don't need this one anymore. And my projection of the price movements is still in play. We poke through the 0.65 level, and this means we have 50-50 possibility to go either way. So from this point we might go up, and we might respect this level, or because we've already break this region, we might go down. But nevertheless, if you decide to invest in this company, and me personally, I think it is a legit company. They have good financials. Their financials, as you can see, they have a total cash of 37.69 million. Their current ratio is 4.33, and it is high above the minimum requirement as for some investors of 1.5. They have net operating cash flow of $1.18 million, and basically it is a legit company from the financial standpoint of view. And in my opinion, you just have to decide why this article was erased from the MarketWatch website. And basically you can read it by your own and decide what facts was in this article. But in my opinion, this is a legit company, and you can add your position even more at each and every red day. And don't get me wrong, I encourage you to buy only in case if you decide to invest in this company. And all the red days, it is the best days to buy, because on the red days you have a discount on the price of the certain company, and only these days allow you to be much more profitable in the long run. So here is basically your next entry point right here, as I mentioned in my previous video. And if we go lower, and it is possible to go on 0.786 level, and even further if market will be red for a long period of time, and it will be another next opportunity for you to invest in this company. And that's it for now. If you like my video, please hit the like button, it helps me a lot, and please subscribe with the notification bell. In this case, you won't miss my next video. See you guys next time. Bye.